Samit Chavan now joins up, Angel Gong. Samit, what's going on? I mean, this is just blanket selling that we are seeing in the mid-cap and the small-cap index. Names like Avanti Feeds, Torrent Power, DV's Lab, Tata Chemicals. No apparent reason these counters are down anywhere in the range of 3 to 4%.
Yes, since last couple of days we have already seen massive selling pressure, especially in the mid-cap and small-cap basket. You know, as far as index goes, 10,750, 10,780 according to us should act as a very strong resistance, and this is what we have seen in last couple of days. If we see yesterday's high also, it was coinciding around major resistance, which was around 10,770. Now it has come to its lower band, so now in the near term 10,558 would be seen as a make or break level. If Nifty slides below this important support level, then we could see extension of this correction toward 10,450 also. So going ahead, you know, one needs to be very careful and one needs to be very watchful how market behaves around this important support level.
Samir, but what do you think is leading to the sell-off? Is it those margin requirements which of course have been increased as per the ASM framework? Is that what is leading to pressure? Because at the end of the day, there's no apparent reason for any of these counters correcting the way they are, right?
Yes, this has been one of the major reasons since last couple of days. If you see, most of the stocks in cash segments, they have been hitting lower circuits since last couple of days. So probably, yes, this is one of the reasons. But if you see before that also, the entire mid-cap and small-cap basket has been seeing, massive selling pressure. So this has one of the reasons, that has clearly weighed down quite heavily in last couple of days. But overall, if you see, mid-cap banking, mid-cap space has been, underperforming the entire benchmark since last, one and a half month. So this is one of the reasons, and probably that's the reason we are seeing this strong selling pressure. Now, one has to see, how mid-cap index also moves around this important level. It has now reached its recent low. So similar to Nifty, one has to be careful how mid-cap index also moves around this important level. So if you see, further slide, another, 1.5% slide in mid-cap index as well, then you could see another breakdown. So in that case, we could see continuation of this fall.
So in that case, I'm assuming the whole mid-cap, small-cap universe is in a void in terms of a trade.
I'm sorry, I didn't get your voice.
In that case, you would avoid trading any of those mid-cap, small-cap names for now?
Yes, obviously. In fact, since last couple of weeks, we were of the opinion that one should stay away from such kind of high beta name, especially, stocks, some of the stocks in the cash segments and from the mid-cap universe also, all those stocks, who are hitting fresh 52 weeks lows or, all-time lows, one should avoid, any kind of bottom fishing in such kind of counter. So we'll avoid for a time being trading in such kind of counters, and, if one has to see any opportunity, so probably those who are in the F&O space, one can go short, such as ICICI Pro is the one stock that we are looking as a shorting opportunity. The stock is clearly trading around its major support level, but since last couple of days we have already seen decent correction, and considering the entire sell-off, we expect this stock to break its important support level. So one can look for good shorting opportunity in such kind of mid-cap names which are available in F&O space.
Right. I don't even know where to start because it's looking so painful suddenly, Samit. It's only gotten back to worst. Let's start with some of the few gainers. There are only a handful of stocks that are holding well. So Reliance Industries is one such name. On RIL at 9:50, time to book your profits. Samit, on Reliance Industries at 9:51, what are you recommending?
I'm really sorry if your voice is breaking, but what I got at Reliance Industries is what you're talking about. Yes, this has been, you know, one of the outperforming stocks since last 3 days. Around 9:20, 9:15, the stock seemed to have formed a strong base, and since last 3 days, we are seeing a good positive traction. So clearly, it is bucking the trend, and looking at the overall structure, we would expect continuation of this move. So 965, 970, this is our next level to watch out for. But as a trader, I don't want to get into this stock at current level, considering the risk to reward ratio. Yes, around 920, 925, it would have been a good bet, but not at current level. But those who have bought it at low level, they should certainly stay put. They can now trail their stop losses somewhere around 940 and expected move toward 960, 965.
Right, that's the word coming in. Reliance Industries, 960, 965 are likely targets on the stock. Constructive on RIL this morning. We'll take Samita. Do you have any long calls that you'd be recommending to our viewers this morning?
See, as far as the long call is concerned, Merico is the one stock. It's a safer bait also. If we look at the overall structure in last one and a half week, this stock has been consolidating. It has already formed a strong base around 310, 350, and since last 3 days we are seeing good buying interest. It is on the verge of, you know, giving a breakout beyond 330, 332. So as a trader, I would rather anticipate and I would rather go long in such kind of market scenario in Marico. Risk reward is quite favorable. One can keep a stop loss around 318, and I would expect a decent move towards 338, 340.
Right. What are you doing with mid-cap IT names? I'm not sure why Tata Lexi is coming under the kind of pressure it is, but the open interest there is also fairly large. Sub 1200 now on Tata Lexi. What's the trade?
See, all these stocks have seen a massive rally in last 3 to 4 months, so it's a time to consolidate a bit now. As far as Tata Elxsi is concerned, 1250, 1260 precisely acted as a very strong resistance, and since last 3 days, we are seeing the stock correcting a bit. So this correction can continue a bit, wherein 1170, 1160, these are the next level to watch out for. But within, you know, mid-cap IT space, Exaware is the one stock. It's on the verge of a breakdown from its near-term supports of, say, 425, 424. So one can go short in Exaware at current level also. One can keep a stop loss around 434, which seems to be an intraday resistance as well. And I would expect a continuation of this correction at least towards 412, 410 over the next few days.
Any short candidates that you picked up on this morning, Sameet?
ICSA Pro is the one stock that we have already talked about. Apart from this, you know, Zee Entertainment is the one stock. After a long consolidation of nearly 2 to 3 weeks, the stock has broken down from its major support of 550. So we expect continuation of this fall, 530, 525, these are the next level to watch out for. So one can go short at current level, use any minor bounce back to go short, and keep a stop loss around, say, 562. Apart from this, Voltas is the one stock that we have picked in this morning also. After a consolidation of nearly a couple of weeks, stock has broken down from a support of 530. If we look at the overall activity in the, you know, future segment also, we can see good shorts getting built in this counter as well. So we expect continuation of this correction. Our next target would be somewhere around 495, 490 for this counter. One can go short at current level, keep a stop loss around 536.
Right. What are you doing with real estate names? It's an opportunity to trade there. Real estate index is also under very heavy selling this morning.
No, we'll avoid for a time being. I don't know, DLF is the one stock that we have been closely tracking. Since last 3-4 days, this stock has been correcting. precisely from its major support of 210, but this is not the level wherein we will go short in DLF, because there is a cluster of support in the zone of say 193-190. So we would rather be closely tracking this particular counter, how it behaves around 190 or 192. So as of now, our stance would be to avoid DLF for a time being, wherein on the higher side 210 to 212, these are the next major resistance to watch out for.
Right. Anything in banks that you're doing? Because it's looking a lot more resilient than the rest of the market, right, Sameet? Do you think it's going to be Bank Nifty that's going to crack down once again?
Yes, since last couple of days, in fact, Bank Nifty, we have already seen massive correction from higher level. Now, if we have to see any particular level for Bank Nifty, 25,950 is the level to watch out for. If Bank Nifty slides and sustains below that level, then we could see another 500-600 point dip in probably next couple of days. So we would be quite watchful around those important levels and how Bank Nifty moves around those levels. So if you have a long position, then it is quite important to keep your stop losses below 25,950, because we expect a sharp correction below this important level. But as of now, we are seeing it as a range wherein 25,950 would act as a support, and on the higher side now 26,500, 26,450 would be seen as major resistance level. ICICI Bank is the one stock that we have been closely tracking, but it is more of a sideways, wherein on the higher side 300 has been acting as a resistance, and immediately on the lower side, if you see, there is a strong support around 280. So if we have to take any trade in ICICI Bank, we will have to wait for a breakout to happen in either direction.
What was the word coming in an idea? I mean, despite positive news for the counter, it's down 7% now.
See, clearly this has been laggard since last 5-6 months. It has already come off quite sharply from the levels of 115-120, and what we saw in last 3-4 days, it was a gradual recovery. So overall, if you see, the trend has been quite negative, and on the higher side, 65-70 we were acting, we were seeing as a major resistance level. So today, if you see, this selling pressure has come from its major resistance zone, which is around 64-65. So we might see continuation of this move. Honestly speaking, there is no trade as such in idea, and we have been avoiding this counter since last couple of months. But within telecom space, Bharti Airtel is the one stock that we have been closely tracking, and we were quite surprised to see this correction that has come today. So if you have to see any particular level for Bharti Airtel, then 378 to 380, these are the next major levels to watch out for.
Well, thanks, Sameet. Good talking to you this morning. With that, we're completely out of time, and it's a wrap on FNO Spotlight. While you take the break, hear out, you are part of Dalton Capital Advisors on a stop investment bets.